Hi students, as part of online video presentation on dissection of human body, we are going to see the dissection of sole of foot. Make a longitudinal incision from the tip of the middle toe to the prominence of the heel. Then another transverse incision across the roots of the toes. Reflect the skin flaps. After the incisions were made, we reflected the skin along with the superficial fascia to see the deeper structures. The deep fascia of the sole is the central part. It has got three parts: the medial part, central part, and lateral part. The central part is thickened and it is known as the plantar aponeurosis, whereas the medial and lateral parts are very thin and that covers the muscle, the abductor hallucis and the abductor digiti minimi. If you see the attachment of the plantar aponeurosis, it is attached proximally to the medial process of the calcaneal tuberosity. Here is the medial process of the calcaneal tuberosity, and this is the lateral process. And distally, if you trace it, this plantar aponeurosis divides into 5 slips. For the 5 toes. This one is for the big toe, that's the other slip. The third one is here, and this one is the fourth, and here is the fifth. The interval between these slips, you can see the plantar digital nerves and vessels. These plantar digital nerves and vessels, which will divide into 2 proper digital nerves at the interdigital cleft between the toes. And here you can see another nerve, which is the proper digital nerve coming from the medial plantar nerve to the medial side of the big toe. And the on the lateral and medial border of the plantar aponeurosis, you have a longitudinal furrow which actually transmits the tiny cutaneous nerves and vessels to the skin and superficial fascia. The one which is coming from here are from the medial plantar nerve and vessels, and the nerves, tiny nerves are there. You can see they are cut while reflecting the skin. So you will find a series of small vessels and nerves along the lateral and medial aspect of the plantar aponeurosis. And it also corresponds to a septum, medial and lateral intramuscular septum at the borders. Now we are going to cut the plantar aponeurosis and then reflect the flaps distally and proximally to see the underneath structure. We are going to remove the plantar aponeurosis. Once you remove the plantar aponeurosis, you will see the first layer muscles. There are 3 muscles in the first layer. They are abductor hallucis in the medial aspect. In the middle, you have the flexor digitorum brevis, and laterally you have the abductor digiti minimi. And between the intervals between these muscles, you can see the plantar nerves and vessels. You can see the medial plantar nerve, medial plantar artery, lateral plantar nerve, lateral plantar artery. Now we are going to see the origin and insertion nerve supply of this three muscles. The abductor hallucis takes origin from the flexor retinaculum, the inferior aspect. Also, it takes origin from the medial process of the calcaneum. This is the medial process of the calcaneum. The muscle gets inserted into the medial aspect of the base of the proximal phalanx of the big toe. It is supplied by a branch from the stem of the medial plantar nerve. At its insertion, it receives a medial belly of the flexor hallucis brevis. Now, the origin of flexor digitorum brevis, it arises from the medial process, and distally this muscle divides into four tendons, and these tendons pass through the tunnel, fibrous tunnel known as the fibrous flexor sheath, along with the long flexor tendon. And in the flexor sheath, the tendon divides into two slips, giving way for the flexor digitorum longus tendons to pass. So in each one you will find the two tendons, the flexor digitorum brevis and flexor digitorum longus. The muscle is supplied by a branch from the trunk of the medial plantar nerve, and after dividing into two slips, the tendon get inserted into the sides of the middle phalanx. The abductor digiti minimi takes origin from the lateral process of the calcaneum as well as from the medial process of the calcaneum. This muscle goes and gets attached to the lateral side of the base of the fifth toe. The proximal phalanx, lateral side of the proximal phalanx. And now we are going to cut these three muscles to see the second layer of muscle. We will cut the muscles from their origin. And the abductor hallucis is now reflected. The digitorum brevis and the abductor digiti minimi. And you can see the second layer. The second layer contains two tendons and two muscles. The tendons are the flexor hallucis longus tendon, flexor digitorum longus tendon, and two muscles. You have the flexor digitorum accessorius and the lumbrical muscles. There are four lumbricals. They are numbered from medial to lateral. The first lumbrical is here. Here is the second one. The third one and the fourth lumbricals. Now let's see these tendons and muscles. This is the flexor hallucis longus tendon. We have seen the muscle in the posterior compartment of the leg. Here is the flexor hallucis longus, which takes origin from the posterior surface of the fibula, and the tendon passes deep to
reflexa retinaculum and then comes to the sole. As it comes to the sole, it grooves the posterior aspect of the talus, or it passes between the medial and lateral process of the talus and runs like this, and it runs underneath the sustentaculum talus. You can see and this bone which you see here is the sustentaculum talus. The tendon passes beneath it and runs along and enters the fibrous flexor sheath and is surrounded by synovial membrane, and then finally it gets inserted into the base of the distal phalanx. The other tendon which you see is the flexor digitorum longus tendon, and this longus tendon, we have seen it in the leg. This is the longus. This longus takes origin from the posterior surface of the tibia, and it crosses the tendon of the tibia, is posterior from medial to lateral, and runs through the flexor retinaculum, and here then enters the sole, and in the sole it is being crossed by the hallucis longus tendon. So the tendon, it comes from again from medial to lateral, and it crosses this tendon on its inferior aspect or the plantar aspect. As it passes, it gets a slip from the tendon of the flexor hallucis, and that is known as the Turner's slip. This tendon in the sole, it divides into four tendons for the lateral four toes and passes through the fibrous flexor sheath along with the tendon of the flexor digitorum brevis, and it pierces through the tendon, or it passes between the slips, and finally it gets inserted into the base of the distal phalanx. And this muscle can be compared to the flexor digitorum profundus in the upper limb, whereas the digitorum brevis can be compared to the flexor digitorum superficialis, the insertion also of the same type. The two muscles, you have the flexor digitorum accessorius. The flexor digitorum accessorius has got two heads of origin. You have a medial head and you have a lateral head. The medial head takes origin from the medial margin of the plantar surface of the calcaneum and also from the medial surface of the calcaneum, whereas the lateral head takes origin from the lateral margin, the posterior part of the lateral margin. And these two heads of origin embrace the long plantar ligament. This is the long plantar ligament, and the two heads converge and inserted into the tendon, the long flexor digitorum longus tendon. The muscle is supplied by a branch from the nerve that supplies the flexor digitorum accessorius from the trunk of the lateral plantar nerve. And the action It pulls the tendon of the flexor digitorum longus, thereby it orients the tendon to the line of pull of the long flexor. So it helps in flexing the lateral four toes. The lumbricals are arising from the tendon of the flexor digitorum longus. And as I told you earlier, there are four lumbricals. This is the first lumbrical. And these lumbrical muscles are on the medial aspect runs and then gets inserted into the base of the proximal phalanx and to the dorsal digital expansion. The first lumbrical is supplied by the medial plantar nerve. This is the nerve to the first lumbricals. The other lumbricals are supplied by the deep branch of the lateral plantar nerve. Apart from these tendons and muscles, in the second layer, you have the plantar nerves and vessels. You have medial plantar artery, medial plantar nerve, lateral plantar nerve, and the lateral plantar arteries. They're all in the second layer. Now let's see these structures in detail. Now the medial plantar nerve is one of the terminal branch of the tibial nerve. Here is the tibial nerve. The tibial nerve divides into its terminal branch deep to the flexor retinaculum, and the terminal branches are, you have the medial plantar nerve and the lateral plantar nerve. But this division is, instead of being deep to the flexor retinaculum, it's slightly higher up. The medial plantar nerve, if you trace the medial plantar nerve from the trunk, it gives off muscular branches to the abductor hallucis and to the flexor digitorum brevis, and then it gives off plantar digital nerves, one proper digital nerve to the medial side of the big toe, and three common plantar digital nerves, which each one of us divides at the interdigital cleft into proper digital nerves to supply the adjacent sides of the toes. So, and these, from this digital nerves, you have a motor nerve, a branch to the first lumbricals, as well as a branch to the flexor hallucis brevis. Now, so the medial plantar nerve supplies four muscles, and also the through the plantar digital nerve supplies 3.5 toes. So the distribution is same as that of the median nerve. And the lateral plantar nerve, it is one of the terminal branches of the tibial nerve, deep to the flexor retinaculum, and it passes deep to the flexor digitorum brevis and runs towards the base of the fifth metatarsal, where it divides into its terminal branches, a deep nerve and a superficial branch. This is the deep branch. The superficial branch gives off the plantar digital nerve to the lateral side of the little toe and the adjacent sides of the little and the fourth toes. And apart from these digital branches, it also supplies the flexor digiti minimi brevis and also the introsia of the fourth intermetatarsal space. The deep branch, it runs deep to the adductor hallucis and supplies most of the intrinsic muscles of the foot. So the distribution of the lateral plantar nerve is similar to that of the ulnar nerve, supplying 1.5 toes and most of the intrinsic muscles of the sole of the foot. The arteries, you have the medial plantar artery, which is a terminal, one of the terminal branches of the posterior tibial artery, which runs along the medial aspect, gives off branches to the neighboring structure and branches corresponding to the branch of the medial plantar nerve. The other one, the lateral plantar artery, is a little larger than the medial plantar artery. It's one of the terminal branches of the posterior tibial artery, deep to the flexor retinaculum, and it follows the lateral plantar nerve, lying lateral to the nerve, and runs towards the base of the fifth metatarsals, where it turns medially. Deeper to the third layer, forming an arch known as the plantar arch, which is completed by the artery coming from the dorsal side, the arcuate artery in the first intermetatarsal space. From this plantar arch, we will see the arch later, you will get the metatarsal arteries, the four metatarsal arteries, and also a proper digital artery to the medial side of the big toe. These metatarsal arteries will divide into proper digital arteries, and they are connected to the dorsal metatarsal arteries through the distal and proximal perforating arteries. The third layer of muscle are confined to the distal half of the foot, that is, it is over the metatarsal bones. We have already seen some of the muscles. We can cut all these tendons to see the deeper muscles. And without cutting, I would like to show you the third layer of muscles. Here you can see this is the flexor hallucis brevis. Flexor hallucis brevis, which chiefly takes origin from the plantar surface of the cuboid bone, and it divides into two bellies, a medial one and a lateral one. The medial one fuses with or joins the tendon of the hallucis, abductor hallucis, and gets inserted into the base, medial side of the base of the proximal phalanx. At the point of insertion, you may find a sesamoid bone. The other one, the lateral head, joins with the adductor hallucis. Adductor, this is the adductor hallucis. It has got two heads, but this one is a oblique head of the adductor hallucis, and it fuses or joins with that and gets inserted into the lateral side of the base of the proximal phalanx of the big toe. And similarly, this tendon also has got a sesamoid bone. So there are two sesamoid bones here at the point of insertion of this muscle, the flexor hallucis brevis. And you have the second muscle, the adductor hallucis. This is the oblique head of the adductor hallucis, which takes origin from the bases of the second, third, and fourth metatarsal bones. And there is another head, which is a transverse head, which takes origin from the capsule of the second, third, and fourth metatarsophalangeal joints, which is not exposed. We will see them later. These two heads, so a transverse head and there's an oblique head. This is the oblique head, and these two heads join, and together with this lateral belly is attached to the lateral aspect of the base of the proximal phalanx. The third muscle which is in the third layer, is the flexor digiti minimi brevis. This is the flexor digiti minimi brevis, which takes origin from the base of the fifth metatarsal bone and is inserted into the lateral side of the base of the proximal phalanx of the little toe along with the abductor digiti minimi. And the nerve supply of these muscles we have already seen, and this muscle is supply, this is the flexor hallucis brevis, is supplied by the medial plantar nerve through the digital branches. The adductor hallucis is supplied by the deep branch of the lateral plantar nerve. And this one, the flexor digiti minimi brevis, is also supplied by the lateral plantar nerve. And the fourth layer muscle is still deeper. It is, you are aware of it, they are intraosseous muscles. They are found in the intermetatarsal spaces. There are 7 intraosseous muscles, of which 3 are the plantar intraosseous and 4 are dorsal intraosseous. And the plantar intraosseous is for the lateral 3 toes, and the dorsal intraosseous are for the intermediate 3 toes. The dorsal intraosseous is bipinnate, taking origin from adjacent sides of the metatarsal bones, whereas the plantar intraosseous are unipinnate muscle, and the dorsal intraosseous are abductors and the plantar intraosseous are adductors. The line of the axis of movement passes through the second toe. In the hand, it passes through the middle finger. All the intraosseae are supplied by the lateral plantar nerve. So we can see the deeper layers, the third, of course, the fourth layer, the intraosseae, later on, once we remove these tendons and the muscles which are there in the superficial layers. Hope you are able to orient yourself to the soul and able to identify all the muscles and nerves. So important things you have to know, these are the intrinsic muscles which are found in the soul. Okay, they are supplied by the either medial or lateral plantar nerves. The medial and lateral plantar nerves are the terminal branches of the tibial nerve, and the blood supply is by the medial and lateral plantar arteries, which are terminal branches of the posterior tibial artery. And these long ones which are there in the first layer extend from one end to the other end, so they will maintain the longitudinal arch of the foot. And there are also tendons are there in the deeper layer, apart from this tendon, fourth layer has got the tibialis posterior tendon, as well as the tendon coming from the lateral aspect, the peroneus longus tendon, which we will see when we do the lateral compartment. With this, we complete the dissection of the sole of foot. Thank you.